Namaskar. Welcome to this module on hospital lighting. I am Dr. Anil Diwan, Professor of Architecture and Head of the Department of Building Engineering and Management at School of Planning and Architecture. In this module, we shall discuss about hospital lighting. What is lighting? Lighting is the deliberate use of light to achieve practical or aesthetic effects. Lighting includes the use of both natural light and artificial light sources like lamps, light fixtures, as well as natural illumination by capturing daylight. Enhanced aesthetics incorporated into fixture design, as well as ability for the luminaire to light architectural details, are certainly important, but patient perceived quality of light and the effects on a healing environment are a critical factor too. Lighting can and does contribute to improved patient outcomes as well as improved facility safety. Types of artificial lighting. Ambient general lighting. It provides an area with overall illumination, also known as general lighting. It radiates a comfortable level of brightness without glare. Task lighting helps you perform specific tasks such as reading, grooming, and preparing and cooking food. Accent lighting adds drama to a room by creating visual interest. As part of an interior design scheme, it is used to draw the eye to houseplants, paintings, sculptures, and other prized possessions. Illuminance. Illuminance is the measure of illumination defined as the ratio of luminous flux incident on an infinitesimal element lighting in different areas, entrance areas, waiting areas, corridors, examination rooms, patient rooms, operation rooms, imaging rooms, NICUs require different lightings. The entrance areas are the first impression that counts in a hospital. This is particularly true for the entrance and reception zones of hospitals, clinics, and care facilities. Harmonious lighting is therefore particularly important, giving its surrounding an inviting character and creating a pleasant, relaxing ambience. Visitors are given a warm welcome and can quickly find their way around. Furthermore, pleasant general lighting can contribute to calming down fearful or stressed patients. Types of fixtures used. Ceiling mounted luminaires, LEDs, suspended luminaires, back wall accent lighting, wall-mounted luminaires. Waiting areas. Lobbies and transition spaces must put the patient and the visitors instantly at their ease. Pay special attention to grading the illuminance and reflectance to successive spaces so that important spaces feel welcoming. Recommended luminance for these areas is 10 to 30 FCs horizontal and 3 to 5 FCs vertical. Wall and ceiling mounted LED luminaires. Corridors. In areas where patients and visitors circulate, factors of key importance are given: guidance, safety, and reassurance, which can be supported by using diffused homogeneous lighting and avoiding dark spots. For corridors where patients are wheeled along on trolleys, it must be taken into consideration that sharp contrast can be extremely uncomfortable when the patients are looking upwards while traveling on a trolley and looking upwards towards the ceiling. Design considerations. Color selection of finish material used in corridors, ceilings, walls and floor in relation to incident reflections is critical in these areas. Minimize extremes of brightness within these spaces. Excessive brightness contrast can disorient residents. Elimination of glare is one of the most important design criteria for corridors. Recessed, indirect or cove lighting are recommended. Properly shielded downlights can also work effectively in these areas. Journal lighting, accent lighting and cove lighting are shown in the slide which you can see on the screen now. Examination rooms. The design considerations for examination rooms are indirect lighting and the ability to switch the level of lighting intensity is critical. Proper placement of luminaires is critical to avoid. Proper placement of luminaires is critical to avoid wheeling reflections in windows and on computer monitors. Additional lighting should be installed directly above work surfaces along with under cabinet lights for counters and downlights over sinks. Skin and tissue tones are best rendered under light source with a high color rendering index of 80 or above. Examination light and dynamic light panel are shown on the slide which you can see on the screen now. Patient rooms. Dynamic white light ceiling modules that provide daylight rhythm with varying light levels and warmer or cooler light, as well as simple examination light for staff. Ambient light. LED based colored light line in cove opposite the bed that can also provide orientation light at night. Reading light. Patient control providing choice for the patients to preset light colors for the cove as well as reading light dimming controls as seen in the slides which you are seeing on the screen now. Glare free light for visual comfort that is seen on the slide above. Design. Very important considerations are color appearance, system control and flexibility, modeling of faces and objects, surface characteristics, horizontal and vertical luminance levels, reflected glare, light distribution on surfaces, light distribution, task plane, uniformity, luminance of room surfaces. Operation rooms, design consideration. The visual requirement in the theater is the detailed examination of tissue, organs and instruments at the site of the operation. It is recommended that a illumination level for lighting the operating areas should be between 2000 to 10,000 lux. Switching and dimming controls should be considered for these areas. Luminaires recessed into the ceiling must be gasketed and UL listed for damp locations. Luminaires should meet the requirements for electromagnetic interference, compatibility, EMI, radio frequency interface and also MIL-STD-463E. This is a CODEL requirement which has to be followed. Reflective glare can be compounded if inappropriate finishes are selected for these areas. High intensity recessed fluorescent luminaires can control ceiling surface glare and also provide the recommended illuminance levels on various task planes and surfaces. High color rendering ramps are recommended in most critical care areas. 85 to 95 CRI should be specified for journal lighting. On your screen, you are seeing the various fittings, fixtures and luminaires that you use in the operation theater. Imaging rooms, MRI suites, due to their intense magnetic polarity created by the diagnostic equipment, demand that luminaires be constructed of non-ferrous materials such as aluminium, brass, certain types of stainless steel and polymers, preventing possible injury to the patient and healthcare technician. Design considerations. Luminaire performance should be weighed against the visual comfort and low brightness. Glare control is more tangible to patients than the amount of light. Fixtures that incorporate non-ferrous materials must be considered when designing MRI areas and also requires increased light levels for certain tasks. Ambient light levels in these spaces can be effectively low during patient treatments, 30 to 35 FCs. The lighting design should provide dimming and switching for adjusting light levels as needed. The ability to switch fixtures on and off is necessary to control general light level for activities such as patient transfer into radiology tables. X-ray viewing and documentation requires dimming general room lighting during viewing, but also requires increased light levels for certain tasks. NICU design considerations. Nursery lighting design should include dimming and switching capability for maximum flexibility. High color rendering lamps should be specified. 85 CRI for recognizing color changes in the skin. General lighting should include luminaires that deliver the appropriate glare-free light distribution patterns for surfaces and task planes. Lighting examination areas for multiple angles helps in avoiding shadows. Lighting requirements for these areas can range from 3 to 5 FCs to 75 to 100 FCs depending on the task. So now we come to the end of this module. I hope you've understood the concepts. Please go through the e-text which we've given with this module. Study the reference materials which we've given. And please discuss your doubts on the discussion forum. Thank you. Jai Hind.